spectrum resort and casino is one step closer to reality in Beloit.
Action today from the federal government is pushing that project toward final approval. As Rose Schmidt explained, city leaders are hoping that last step will come by the end of the summer.
There's corn on the ground here now, but Beloit city leaders are soon hoping this land will become the casino they've worked to get here for years as the project moves one step closer today.
This is fundamentally a game changer for our community.
A 7-year-long project, but a concept that's been discussed for 2 decades in Beloit.
We have a big need to improve our services in law enforcement and in other public safety components, and we don't have a new revenue stream.
Beloit City Manager Lori Curtis Luther says the proposed Ho-Chunk Nation Casino could be that revenue stream.
We're following through on that. We have a resort that we're planning here, the water park, hotel space, conference center space.
Amenities that could soon be on their way, as the Federal Bureau of Indian Affairs has now published a final environmental impact statement.
This is the most significant progress we have seen since the project started in 2012.
The casino and water park would bring an estimated 2,700 new jobs to the area.
We fully believe that almost all of the jobs here in Beloit are going to be Beloit residents.
There's just a few more hurdles to jump through. After a 30-day public comment period, the federal government has to sign off on the deal, sending it to Governor Tony Evers' desk. He's expressed support in the past, but his office issued a statement to us today saying the governor will be carefully reviewing the application and listening to all sides of the issue to ensure fair consideration.
There is no absolute assurance. There is no deadline that we must receive a decision. But I think it is possible, and I'm certainly hopeful that we will receive a final decision yet this summer.
If Governor Evers signs the deal, the city manager says Beloit is ready to move right away on upgrades to these roads with financial help from the Ho-Chunk Nation. In Beloit, I'm Rose Schmidt for News 3 Now.
There has been some opposition from people in Beloit worried about the casino bringing more violence and gambling to the area, but Curtis Luther calls those fears unfounded and says the reality is there's already a lot of gambling opportunity nearby.